In the 80s, people were starting to say things like, sleep is for sissies. The more you can work and the more you can do, the more we've conquered the system.
Much like the hairstyles and fashion choices, our thinking has evolved since then. Take it from this sleep expert.
In study after study, in humans and in animals, you cannot cheat the system.
Sleep, there's more to it than meets the eye. Because although we may look like this on the outside, inside our brain, it's more like this. So let's see what's really going on under the surface of sleep. Sleep is broken down into four stages, 1, 2, 3, and REM. You repeat each of these stages 4 to 5 times over an average 8-hour night.
If your brain is organizing your sleep in the right way, you're gonna get the deepest sleep right away. Because if you only could sleep 4 hours, your brain's gonna make sure you get that deep sleep.
Think about it this way. It would have been tough for cave people to get a consistent 8 hours of sleep. Those who could wake up at the first sign of danger, refreshed and ready to run, would be at a distinct advantage. And the ones who weren't getting deep sleep early on, well, their genetic journey would come to an end.
Each stage of sleep has different brainwave patterns.
Alpha, theta, and delta. Let's get into the nitty-gritty of each.
Stage one sleep is the transition stage of sleep. Muscles start to relax, eye movements start to roll.
Your brain slides from alpha waves to theta waves. If someone wakes you up, you may not even know you've been asleep. During stage two, sudden bursts of brain activity called spindles start spiking into the theta waves. So, what does a spindle do?
We don't know exactly, but it plays some role in memory consolidation. People who have learned a task show more sleep spindles than people who haven't learned.
The best guess so far is that sleep spindles are a sign that your brain is downloading the new information it's taken in that day. Enter delta waves, the deepest, most restorative sleep you get all night.
And that is the stage of sleep where most of your bone repair and muscle repair will occur.
It's also when the greatest amount of growth hormones are secreted, which might be why babies sleep so much. And that brings us to... Everyone's heard of REM, which stands for rapid eye movement. It's the dream stage of sleep when your alpha waves are crackling and your large muscles are paralyzed, so you don't act out your dreams.
Brainwave activity looks similar to what it looks like when we're awake.
Back in the Middle Ages, when people woke up during REM, they thought their paralysis was caused by an invisible demon called an incubus sitting on their chest.
What do you think was what?
After scientists discovered REM in 1952, we finally understood that sleep isn't a passive act. Our brains are actually much more active than we ever could have imagined. So, how do you prep your brain for its nightly busy work? Avoid caffeine late in the day. A compound called adenosine builds up inside you all day long and tells your brain you're getting sleepy. Caffeine blocks adenosine receptors in your brain and the message can't get through, making it harder to fall asleep. Another thing you can do? Sleep in a cool room. Think of it as returning to your caveman roots.
Washing our face, changing our clothes, leaving a body part out from under the covers, particularly our head.
It's called thermal dumping, and it tells your brain it's bedtime. And finally, blue light. It resets your internal clock to dusk, so while your body knows it's night, your brain thinks it's day. If you can't give up tech entirely, there are ways to hack your gadgets to give off orange light instead. Follow these tips, and your journey to the land of dreams will be more pleasurable, effortless, and rejuvenating each and every night.